Choose your lettuce leaf.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Wow.
It's a salad.
Yeah.
It's a salad.
JC, that was delicious.
That must be all Serena. That sounds great.
Well, when you haven't had a salad in 6 months, it's delicious.
Station on 2 for Nanorax. With you
on 2 for Nanorax. Hey, how's your view? Do you want anything different?
View looks great.
No, the view looks great. Thank you.
Now that the experiment is aboard the space station, it's time for the astronauts to get to work. Elaine and Peristew are back in Virginia, and the Nanorax team is back in Texas, where they will perform a ground control version of the experiment being conducted by the crew in space.
The crew members are using the Nanorax plate reader to read the plates. They're analyzing what's in the plate and the migration of fluids between the two chambers that are on the plates. And so we have our ground samples here. These are identical to the ones that are on the space station. And what we're going to do is, as the crew members insert the plates into the plate reader on the space station, we're also going to insert the plates onto the ground unit we have behind me. And that's just to confirm that what we're seeing, any effects that we do end up seeing, is effective of the space environment compared to the ground unit. In summary, what the plate reader does is, it's called, the big fancy word is a spectrophotometer. And it's got a big lamp in it that shines white light, and then it's got a prism or a grating. And the white light shines on the grating, and then it moves to orientate to kind of separate the light into a wavelength. And you get to select which wavelength you want to shine through your samples. We have 6 plates. Each plate takes about 4 minutes, so it's about 30 minutes each. And every time in between, we'll be listening for the crew member to say that they inserted the plate. Then we'll hit the command here. Once the run is done, the crew member will come over and take the plate out, put the new plate in, and it'll repeat for 5 more times.
Station 03, plate 1003 is in the tray.
Yeah, it's reading the plate. It's got a little, the plate sits in there, moves the plate this way, and then the read head moves this way. And a little here, that's kind of the lamp that's in there that turns the lamp on. Sounds like bad techno music.
My crewmate actually was the first one to start this experiment. And I took over for him and said, hey, what experiment is this? What are we doing? And he looks at me and he says, I'm not sure. So we called down to the ground, to mission control.
And I know that part of this is we're looking at a gel that can release antibiotics, kind of slow release to a wound site. But I don't know what happened to that plate in the Nanorax reader this morning and then kind of what's going on this afternoon.
What we're looking for is how the drug migrates through the gel over time, which is why we're scanning the plates 2 times a day for this 2-week run.
I like that answer. That's very cool. Thank you for finding that out.
No problem.
So this is 15 days. It's twice a day, and they're typically in the middle of the night, which is the morning for the crew on space station, and then usually sometime in the late morning, early afternoon here. But Kyle's been running the show. He's been getting up every 6 hours, 8 hours, 7 hours to do this. It's kind of fun in a way. I get to play astronaut on the ground, so that's always fun.
After 15 days of running the experiment, the researchers have a lot of valuable data about how hydrogels behave in microgravity. To learn even more, the samples will come back to Earth for further analysis. For the last leg of their journey, the samples will return to Earth in the same Dragon capsule that gave them a ride to microgravity. After Dragon splashes down in the Pacific Ocean, it's taken to the port of Long Beach, where NASA will be ready to retrieve the precious cargo.
Splashdown for Dragon was on the Sunday, I believe. And so NASA has a group called Cold Stowage and Cargo Manifest, and they go out and pick up the payloads from Dragon. And then they distribute it to people at LA or whoever needs them there, and then they bring them also here to Johnson Space Center. And so now I'm out front the Cold Stow office, And I just picked up module 74, which is our tympanogen project. And they hand it to me and I put it in my cooler and then I drive it over to our office where it's gonna sit until we fly up to the tympanogen office in Richmond, Virginia to do the final phase of the experiment, which is removing the samples out of the reactor microplates. We're really proud to take part in this really, really interesting experiment.
When we first got our gels back, it was already exciting because space never loses its cool. And so we had these plates where, oh my God, these are what the astronauts touched. And so we opened up and they've been to space and back, and now they're in our lab.